Welcome back to Noise Shark, folks. We are continuing our adventures in Stardew Valley. And today we're going to do a little bit of foraging. We've done a little bit of clearing out here since the last episode. We just created a nice little path that will allow us to get down to the southern exit of our farm. Come on. And we're just making that path a little bit wider. So as the grass and twigs start to respawn in here, we'll have just a little bit more time to make sure we can get in and out rapidly. So, all right, we got a geode. You found a geode. The local blacksmith can break it open for you. Who knows what might be hidden inside? Awesome. That is super awesome. I had, in my last playthrough, gotten really frustrated with geodes and... Oh my goodness, what am I doing here? And even discarded them at many points in exchange for other far less valuable resources. I will not be making that same mistake. I came to find out that they're incredibly useful to have. And we are going to harvest them. All right, so back inside we go. I'm not sure if I watched TV today or not. Fortune teller. Oh, you know what? It is, and I was very happy today. We left off on the last episode. And I just don't have enough energy to go forage out on the beach today. We just kind of screwed that one up, but that's all right. We're going to go to sleep for the night so that we can have full energy tomorrow on the sixth day of spring. And just get these out of here. All right, so let's take a look at the old tube. The weather report tomorrow is clear and sunny. And, nope, that's not what I want. Come on. The fortune teller. We'll have a little extra luck today. Wonderful. All right, so we're going to drop off all of our goods here. And look at that. Isn't that nice? All right, so we are going to save three of these guys and sell the rest. Next thing, we've got to water everything. Let's go ahead and take care of that right off the bat. There we go. Nice and watered. Let's head on down to the beach and see what we can find if the fates actually are going to favor us today, or if we are going to have to kind of make it on our own. We also need to pick up some more seeds. Let's see. It's only 7:20. We can't do that just yet. We're going to hold off on breaking open that geode for the moment, though. We're going to wait until we've got a little bit of extra cash, maybe a couple of extra farms growing. Might take one more day based on foraging and crop sell, whatever we get for the crops that we've sold there. So let's head over to the tidal pools. Do we find anything over here that is valuable? We've got some coral, which is nice. That should sell for about 100 gold. And it looks like that is potentially it. All right, that's all right, though. We're just going to take a quick pass through here. There are also worm tiles on the beach. We'll see if we can find one here. It doesn't look like there's any over here. But they... these guys right here. These guys... What is this? This is not what I expected. You found a lost book. The library's collection has expanded. That is fantastic. Normally, what you find there is clay. And I had a lot of trouble in the last series when I was playing, trying to get clay. It was just one of those things where I ended up digging this whole beach out with the hoe. And I am okay. That's... fantastic. It's not what I was expecting to find by any means, but that's still pretty cool. All right. So apparently those worm tiles also drop books. Let's go ahead and get those turned in because I've never seen these. I've never seen the books being turned in. So this is going to be a new adventure. In we go. And how you doing there, Gunther? It doesn't seem like you have anything to donate to the museum. Better get out there and do some treasure hunting. Oh, I see. I can. This is a book by Marnie's. Animals are very sensitive. They like to pet every day and prefer to eat grass outdoors than dry hay. They don't like being outside in the rain, though happy animals produce higher quality products. Okay. On foraging, the local woods and mountains are a great place to find wild produce. A good forager will clear out any weeds, stumps, or stones from these areas so the wild produce has plenty of space to grow. Expert foragers know the secret to cultivating wild food so it can be grown on the farm. Isn't that amazing? That is rather amazing. And this, Oh, I only had two books. All right. Getting ahead of myself there. That's awesome, though. I like that those have little snippets of information that you can use in the farm. So we're going to go ahead and exit stage left here. Oh, no, we're not. We got to go to the store. We're going to go to Pierre's and get some more seeds because right now our crops are not producing. So, oh, that's not, that's the saloon, not the store. It was a nice try, though. It's a very nice try. All right. How you doing there, Pierre? So we're going to go. Perfect. We can buy 9 more, which is good. Hopefully we'll have a positive rate of return on these. Because they do grow very fast. And we want to be able to start cycling up pretty quickly here. So back over we go. And let's go ahead and clear some of those out. And there we go. Let's go ahead and refill our water can while we're here. And what else can we do here? We need to, we should head over to the mines. I'll bet we can get some good stuff there. But it's 12 o'clock. Let's head south and get some forage because we need some food to make sure that, I mean, if we go to the mines, we're gonna tucker ourselves out super fast and we're not gonna be able to get anything really effective done. So we're gonna go south to where we can forage and grab ourselves some spring onions, some dandelions. Maybe, I think there's some roots we can get down here as well. More dandelions. And these guys do give us energy and health returns. So here we are. We've got that. And we're going to see what happens if we spread this out even farther. I've never tried this, and that book said that, you know, you can cultivate them. So we're going to just let that do its thing. And I think that's all we can get down here. So let's head back over this way. We'll check back there in a day or two and see if that actually helps. Maybe if we get more or less, we'll find out. So we're going to go ahead and head over here, see if there's any more forage that we can pick up. We do need to start working on relationships here. Maybe we'll head back into town. Oh, good. We got a high quality daffodil. Let's go ahead and clear out these weeds. Maybe that'll help. All right. Come on, get out of there. Just a couple more. All right, all cleared out. Hey, birds. And let's see here. So we've got some stuff to sell. We've got some stuff to build up our energy. We're going to head back over here. And... oh, we've got an extra 100 gold that we didn't even notice there. That's going to be nice and handy. Who's that? Who are you? Have we met you? Oh, I can read it on your face. You're going to love it here in Pelican Town. If you're ever looking for something to do in the evening, stop by the saloon. That's where I work. Well, thanks, Emily. I will certainly do that. And we need to introduce ourselves to some people here. Why, hello and welcome to our little community, dear. You can call me Granny if you like. Well, thank you, Evelyn. That's very nice of you. And who are these folk over here? Hello, you must be NoiseShark, the new farmer. I'm Caroline. Oh, hi, Caroline. Oh, you aren't exactly how I imagined, but that's okay. I'm Jody. Well, thanks, Jody. Have a flower. Blech, I hate this. Yeah, piss off. How about you? No, no, no. Ah, you people are butts. Don't want my presence. That is the other thing that's very difficult for me. I will eventually have the wiki up on the, you know, my other monitor here. So that I can, we're going to get, for now we're going to sell the mixed seeds and we are going to get, let's see, we've got 200 gold. Going to get another 9 parsnip seeds. The reputation, you know, what do people like? What do people not like? I just don't have the headspace available anymore to try and keep track of all of that information along with everything else. I'm super impressed that one guy built all of this and has been maintaining it. That's incredible. My hat's completely off to him for making such an incredibly fun game. But it's just too much for me. So I may either look into, say, a mod that tells me what do people like, what do people not like, or print it out and reference it while I'm recording. Something to just make sure that I'm not wasting gifts like that. All right. 5:10 p.m. We're still at 50% energy, and everything is planted and watered. We're going to harvest a little bit more wood here so we can start building some paths maybe, some more chests. We are going to get this rocking fast. And we're going to go ahead and get all this grass out of here. Get out. Now, we don't want to get rid of all of the grass just yet. We will need to save some so that when we get animals, we can build a silo. That's actually going to be the very, very first thing that we build. Structure-wise, is going to be a silo. Because if we get the chicken hutch first, you end up spending 50 gold a day on your chickens to buy hay. Or you can build a silo first, and as you're working on the farm and getting everything done, you accumulate additional hay for your chickens or your animals in general, and you don't have to worry about it as much. Well, you don't have to worry about it at all, really, which is, you know, very, very important to me. Maximizing my efficiency in something like this, I want to make sure, because the day-night cycles are so short already, or not short, but they run by so quickly that it's, I get really kind of disheartened when the, you know, I look at the day's progress that I've done in game and I'm just like, well, I didn't get anything done. So we're going to really try and mitigate that. So let's drop off sap and onions and coal, and we're getting closer there, and let's head to bed here. 7:30. Did we watch TV today? We did. In we go for the night. Sweet dreams. All right, level 1 farming, plus 1 watering can proficiency, plus 1 hoe proficiency. We can now craft a scarecrow, which is fantastic. And we can now make basic fertilizer. Level 2 foraging. plus one axe proficiency, which is awesome, and a new cooking recipe, the survival burger, which I don't believe we can access that until we get our house expanded. So we've got another 600 gold. I'm sorry, I didn't read the values there. But let's watch our daily television weather report. Tomorrow is going to be clear and sunny. Nice. Fortune teller. The spirits are very displeased. They will do their best to make your life difficult. That is unfortunate. And the Queen of Sauce. And we are going to learn how to make stir fry. Excellent. All right, off we go again. We've got some mail. Dear Farmer Noise Shark, I'd like to apologize for joking about your grandpa's old cottage when we first met. It's really a nice little house. However, you might need some more space someday. That's where I can help. If you bring me some raw materials and pay a fee, I can expand your house. The first expansion I offer includes a kitchen. With a kitchen, you'll be able to cook any recipes you've learned. Anyway, I hope you're starting to feel at home in Stardew Valley. Your local carpenter, Robin. Well, thank you very much, Robin. We will certainly take you up on that offer eventually. But for today, we are going to water our crops. And in the circle we go. One more. There we are. Refill our watering can. And let's go ahead and grab some of these spring onions. Oh. And let's head over to the... Well, you know, we don't need to go to the beach because fate is not with us today. We could craft that scarecrow, which we will need. Let's go ahead and do that. We're going to need coal sticks and fiber, I believe. Crafting. Scarecrow. Perfect. And we're going to put you... Let's see. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now, is it 8 tiles that they protect? Has limited radius, about 8 tiles. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. 14. I think we're going to do another line of beans here as well. So we're going to put you right there and see how that does for us. Gives us another 100 gold. We're up to 814 gold. Let's get into town here. And before we do that, get rid of this stuff we don't need. All right, let's get into town. Let's get ourselves another 3 beans and some more sets of 9 seeds so that we can get these 3x3s going. Oh, and here we are going to learn about the community center. Oh, hi there. What an eyesore. This is the Pelican Town Community Center, or what's left of it anyways. Come on. It used to be the pride of the pride and joy of the town, always bustling with activity. Now just look at it. It's shameful. You know, he looks like a guy who might talk like this. Now just look at it. It's shameful. These days, the young folk would rather sit in front of the TV than engage with the community. You know, the irony is not lost on me that I'm sitting here playing a game about going outside and gardening. But listen to me, I sound like an old fool. You do sound like an old fool. Joja Corporation has been hounding me to sell them the land so they can turn it into a warehouse. Don't you dare, sir. I will smack that hat off your head. Pelican Town could use the money, but there's something stopping me from selling it. I guess old-timers like me get attached to relics of the past. Oh, well. If anyone else buys a Joja Co. membership, I'm just gonna go ahead and sell it. What an arbitrary thing to decide to sell the community landmark on. Sigh. Here, let's go inside. All right, let's go inside the dilapidated condemned building here. Oh, look at this. Question mark? What's this? I guess Vincent and Jess must have been playing in here. This place is even more dilapidated than I remember. Yeah, thanks for bringing me in. I'm glad I got my tetanus shots. And oh my god, there's a slime thing. It's so happy. Look at it. What? Nothing. What's the matter? Are you ill? You saw something? I wouldn't be surprised if this place was full of rats. Then why did you invite me in? That is not a rat. Oh, he's gonna think we're crazy now. You're worrying me, Noise Shark. Look, I think I'm going to head home. I need some lunch. Ah, get out of here. Hey, I'll keep this place unlocked from now on. Maybe if you can help catch that rat if you have some extra time. All right. Yes, we will. All right, off we go. 8:30 a.m. What do we got here? Rat problem. Investigate the community center. All right, let's do that really quick because that'll knock another quest out. And let's see here. A strange thing. Okay, so we have investigated the community center. And I believe that will also trigger a follow-up quest with the wizard! The wizard who will unlock the seasonal challenges for us. All right, 9:20, so Pierre should be open. And let's see. We haven't done any potatoes. Cauliflower seeds. We've got one batch of those. We're gonna do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 of those. 3 of those. And we won't be able to do a full run of those. Let's see. We haven't done any flowers. I don't know what the sell rate is on these. We're going to go ahead and stick with that. That's another batch that we can start growing. We're going to take a quick peek down at the beach and see if there's anything valuable that we can find down there. Who are you, little girl? Oh, that's Penny. Hello. The weather's interesting today, don't you think? It certainly is. Do I have anything that I can give you? I don't think you like spring onions. I'm pretty sure you like flowers and books and things. And I don't have any of those, so let's see here. Little worm, ornamental fan. Ooh, Gunther will tell us about that. Lovely. Any other tiles? And I don't think luck was with us today, so I don't imagine that we're going to get anything too fancy down here, but it's always worth the look. Plus, it'll help to raise our foraging skill, which we can get some nice little perks out of that. I don't think anything spawns down there. I think that's just another spot to go fishing. And let's head back up. We're going to go ahead and turn this in, this ornamental fan. Any more worm tiles? Nope. All right. And then we'll head back to the farm. Through the... do we want to check the forage today? Luck was not on our side. I don't think we're going to check it today. I think we're going to wait and see. Oh, we're going to go ahead and skip this cutscene. He just talks about there's nothing in the museum, and if we could go find artifacts to donate to the museum, he would be much obliged. And we're going to go ahead and... Let's see. Where do we want to put this? We're we're going to put these over here. Journal updated. Beautiful. So we've got another. So we're up to 704 gold. Let's go back to Pierre's. Let's really maximize our farming. All right, Pierre, what do you got for me here? So we've got some of these. We've got some of these. Let's do some more cauliflower. Cauliflower is 80 a pop, though. We're going to do potatoes. There we go. All right. Back to the old... Ooh. Oh, it's Mayor Lewis's birthday party. Birthday today. Let's give him... You know what? Screw Mayor Lewis. He's going to sell the community center to Jojo Mart. He can suck a bag of D's. All right. Back we go. Once you know it, there's forage that I want there. And I just don't have room for it yet. Let's go ahead and sell those guys. We're going to go grab that leek. And get these next batches going. So first thing we need to do is right here. And we'll give these guys some water as well. And from here, we're going to skip a space. And 1, 2, 3. Oh, and some nice clay. Perfect. And from here, there we go. Now, we also have the ability to make some basic fertilizer, which requires 2 sap. We have 42 sap. We are going to make a bunch of sap, or a bunch of fertilizer, and get that in the ground here. And same thing here. Perfect. We should have done that there, but, you know, we forgot. So what do we have? We have parsnips, 4 days, and 6 days for the potatoes. So we're going to go ahead and... Right there. And right there. Let's go ahead and water all of these. And I believe that is going to be it for today's episode. Thank you so much for joining us once again in Stardew Valley. If you enjoyed, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And we will see you fine folks in the next video. Bye-bye now.